so you know, I came here and made a selection of songs that I'll share with you. And there are a number of songs that I actually omitted. And I omitted them because I thought, first of all, I've done these songs so many times, and you know. But the thing is, it doesn't matter how many times I've done them, the message still rings true for those who God wants to hear it. And so, I sang the song so long ago, I don't know if I can completely remember the lyrics, but I think that's all I need to hear it here today. And the reason I want to share it is, we do a lot of things, you know, especially the place you are in life right now. You have a lot of ginger, you know what I mean? You have a lot of energy, a lot of blood. And you want to do so much, and it's good, and it's good. But, so I'm 36, guys. That means that I'm older than, I don't know how many percent of the people in this room, probably 80-something. But, so when you start to get to your mid-30s, you start to ask yourself, why do I even do what I do?
Yes.
You know what I mean? It just, so you're like, okay, fine. Especially if God has been good to you and the little things in life that you want, you know, one way or another, God has granted them. You don't have all of them yet too.
Yes.
But you have the ones that are important to you at least. You know what I mean? You know, you're getting on with life. And you start wondering, why do I do what I do? And then you begin to realize, you guys are fortunate enough to realize it early, that there is a purpose. There's a purpose behind your existence. There's a purpose behind your life. Beyond coming to this world, you know, going to Bangkok or some other school, getting a degree, working for some civil service or some government, or doing your own business, making a lot of money or not making enough, whichever it is. You know, but our prayers need to be making more than enough.
Amen.
You know what I mean? And getting married, you know, and dying. Wow! It's just came to this world and go leave. I need to rise and die. There's got to be much more to this. I like sugar. Sugar is great. I'm trying to stay away from sugar now and do more honey. But guess what? Even greater than sugar and honey for me is whatever they say the world's about to end. I think of a number of things. When I was much younger, I used to be like, man, I've not gotten married and I've not had enough sugar. But I began to realize that there are some things that are more important.
That's sugar.
You know, how someone else can open their mouth and say, Gloria is a fantastic person because she loves. Somebody can say, you know, I was dealing with this thing, but Yetunde told me one word. Somebody can say, you know, Kemi said something that stuck with me. You know, just that ability to impact something into someone. Maybe your mate, maybe someone younger, maybe someone older. And so I realized that when that thing happens, you know, the God that you represent comes through. And sometimes that's as much of God as some people would see. And so I learned that a bigger purpose for me to do all the things I do is, at the end of the day, let it glorify God. Because if it doesn't, it really makes no sense.
Yes.
It doesn't matter how, you know, how, I mean, just think about it. It doesn't matter how, think about someone like Nathaniel Bassey, who takes his Instagram page that everybody is using to show hair on fleek, to show, you know, couple goals, Squad girl, you know, savage. And Nathaniel takes this same tool, turns it around, and over 70,000 people come on every night to give God praise. God will ask us questions. God will ask us questions. I hope you answer not the hair of me. I don't know what that does necessarily. But I'm just saying this to say, guys, look, whatever it is you do in your life, ultimately, let it move somebody forward. And most importantly, let it give God praise. Sometimes it might not even be the most pleasant situation. Take me, for instance, you know, as one line, like, wow, God. Until I went to primary school, I didn't know of any other blind person other than myself. I'm like, God, you chose me. Like, in the whole, I grew up in the barracks. I'm like, in this whole full barrack full of children, me alone, I'm the one that you say, I will not drive a car. I don't think this is very fair. But guess what? I look at a lot of those kids today. I have one of them, my very good friend. We call him Imakuda. You see, the thing with him is every time I see him, and I'm not saying this because I want to make fun of anybody, every time I see him, like, I'll find him something now, and I'm like, okay, I'm going to find him something, that's why he's my guy. But guess what? God has used my story to tell an even bigger story, which is that he can pull something and pull praise out of his life. I'm saying that to say, sometimes it might even be an unpleasant situation, but guess what? It is still an opportunity to give God praise. So that's the basis behind the song I'm going to share with you. Thank you.
When my work is done and my time has come, and you call me home to you, when people ask how did I live my life, let people say in praise of you. And if the world remembers anything that I may have left behind, let my greatest legacy, Lord, be that I praise you with my life. For my life is nothing that's of worth if it cannot give you praise. So let the gifts that you have given me be an everlasting praise to thee, and my motivation always be, Lord, that I live in praise of you. Ooh.